In this video, we're going to be talking about the lungs. We're going to include the right and the left. Let's talk about identifying some structures first. This is going to be the apex, and each lung has an apex, right? It's going to be the top. We're going to have the base, and it's going to be the base of the lungs is right here and sitting directly on this diaphragm. We're going to talk about the fissures now. And so let's talk about how you can tell actually if they're right and left. So we know that this is the right because we're staring at the anterior view, right? We see the heart. We're like, okay, this should be the right. That should be the left. But we're actually going to rotate this lung model so you can see that there are three lobes on the right, and it's because of two fissures. It's going to have the horizontal fissure right here, and we're also going to have the oblique fissure right here. That leaves you with the upper, middle, and lower lobes. You may have heard them as the superior, middle, or intermediate, and inferior lobes. Now let's go ahead and go to the left lung. And so the left lung is going to have two lobes, and that is resultant because of one fissure. And this, you guessed it, is the oblique fissure. But there's also another structure in the way that's going to make sure that it's only going to have two lobes. And if you notice, it's the heart. So on this side, the lung kind of comes almost straight down. But if you notice on this left one, it's kind of got a hook in it, a little curve. And that curve is actually called the cardiac notch. And the reason is if we pull this off right here, our heart will fall out. But you're going to notice that the heart goes to the left side. And this notch right here, this space, is where the heart can sit and pump without interfering with the expansion of the lung. Okay. So we're going to talk about, we're going to pop these off. And actually, let's talk about something else on the outside. So on the outside, so we're going to talk about pleura. So pleura meaning lung. We're going to talk about the visceral and parietal pleura. So the pleuras, the visceral pleura, think on like a vest. You wear your vest directly on your body. These lungs, the viscera meaning organ, are going to have the visceral pleura, and it's a serous membrane, right? It's going to help secrete lubrication so that the lung, as it expands, isn't going to be dealing with friction. And the parietal pleura, parietal, think wall of rib, right? Or the lining of that thoracic cavity, where these lungs are going to sit inside their own little pleural cavity. So that lining, that parietal, think of that as the parent. The parent is going to hug the child wearing the vest. So parietal is the outside lining. Visceral is the lining directly on the organ that we're needing. And now we're going to go inside. And so the heart, it's a big part of this because the pulmonary artery or the pulmonary trunk is going out. In this case, we're going to see this left branch here that's going to the left lung. This is going to be the aorta and the aortic arch. This is going to be the superior vena cava before it breaks off to this brachiocephalic and off from there. So let's flip to the back side of this heart. So on the back side of this heart, we're going to have, remember, that's the left pulmonary artery. You're also going to have the right pulmonary artery. And that is actually going to hook up right here. That's where it's going to deposit into this right lung. So you're thinking artery, Annie, arteries are supposed to be red, but they're actually not color-coded. They're determined by function. So artery, think away. That deoxygenated blood is going away from the heart. It's going out to the lung to be reoxygenated. And the veins return. They're going to bring oxygenated blood, in this case, back to the left atrium of the heart. And we're going to over the bronchioles now. And so just so you know, bronchial tree. That's kind of referring to all of this. And if you look like it, it does look like a tree. So on this side, to kind of give you a little more of the color coding, the light blue is going to be the bronchioles. The red and blue are going to be the vasculature. And so we just talked about how these reds are going to be the veins and how those blues are going to be the arteries. So back at this model, the trachea actually goes all the way down here and up to here. And so it's going to be that hollow tube held open by those 9 cartilage rings. And the trachea is going to have these branches. Remember, this is a bronchial tree. It's going to have the main bronchus, bronchi for plural. So right main bronchus, left main bronchus. That's going to separate off into the lobar branches, the lobar bronchi. The lobar bronchi, so we know that there's 3 lobes, right? There's 3 lobes on the right side, 2 on the left. And on the left, there's going to be 2 lobar bigger segments. So lobar 1, lobar 2, lobar 1, two, and three. From there, we're going to have the segmental bronchi. The segmental bronchi are ensuring that each of the lobes is actually having further divisions, further bronchi going into it. And lastly, we're going to have bronchioles, which are going to be smaller, even smaller segments. And then we're going to have finally terminal bronchioles. And that's going to take us to where those bronchioles are going further and deeper infiltrating all segments of the lung.